How's everyone doing? I'm back from my vacation. From my long, long vacation. I'm finally back. So happy to be here. So happy to see you guys. Chew King, hello. How are you doing, my friend? Thank you so much for resubscribing. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Did you guys hear that? Just a car alarm going off in my neighborhood. It's a safe neighborhood, I swear. How's everyone doing? I am so happy to be back. Oh, should we start with some songs? Should we do some music today? What do you guys think? I've got some songs I haven't played in quite some time, and maybe I will play some of those songs. Maybe that is what I will do. Why don't I start with, you know what, I'll start with Blinding Lights since it's in my queue already. Why don't I do that? Why don't I do that? If I can find the right chords. Are these the right chords? Where's my capo? I feel like every time I go away for a while and then I come back, I like can't remember how to stream or like what my usual order of operations. I'm always like so confused. So bear with me, friends. Bear with me while I get back into the groove of things. I'm just gonna do it anyways. Looks a little bit weird, but we're doing it anyways. Kinmin, hello, welcome back. Well, who do we have here? It's me. I'm back. How are you guys? How's everybody doing? How are your weeks? What's new? What's going on? I missed you all. I missed you guys. I'm so happy to be back. Drunk Bard, hello. Good to see you too. Can I introduce myself? I seem new to Twitch. Hello, everyone. Hello, I'm Taylor. You may not remember me. It's been so long since I've streamed, but I'm back on Twitch. I'm back for my big return. Is that sufficient, Aaron? Is that a sufficient introduction? Should I play Blinding Lights for you guys? Let me know if there's... Sounds like there's a cat trying to get in. Let me know if there's anything that you guys want to hear. I would love to play you some requests. I'm probably going to do like a little bit of a shorter stream today. I probably won't do the full 2 hours just because I'm still recovering from my back-to-back. I had a back-to-back wedding and bachelorette party, like back to back and across an ocean. So it's been a pretty big last few days. It's been a huge last few days. But I'll tell you my tales a little later on. Well, let me know if there's anything you guys want to hear. I would love to play you some requests. It was so fun. And like, my heart is so full. My spirit is so full, but my body is so weak right now. My body is so weak. My spirit is strong, but my body is weak. Okay, here is Blinding Lights for you guys.
Trying to call. I've been on my own for long enough. Maybe you could show me how to love. Maybe going through withdrawals. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Baby, I look around and Sin City's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me.
Blinding Lights for you guys. Kinman, would you do me a favor and add some more like 4 month, 5 month, 3 month songs to my queue? I didn't have time to do it before the stream started because I was having trouble tuning my guitar. Megs, hello. I was worried that you were gonna be here today. demanding something of me. I was worried. I was scared. And here you are. How are you doing? Did I learn it? You know what, guys? Let me tell you something. I am not very good at guitar, okay? I am not very good at guitar. I'm mid at best. I'm a solidly mid guitar player. So, That is what I'm going to say about that. I am so, so incredibly mid. Learn a song is learn a song. You're absolutely right, my friend. You're absolutely right. Hold on. Just one moment, please. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay. It's not gonna be good. Don't get excited, okay? I am doing my best. I'm doing my best. Don't get excited. I'm not a guitar player, okay? I'm not a guitar player. Let's just start with that. How am I doing? I was just saying, my spirit and my soul are so full and my body is so weak. I'm like so happy and like so full of love. I saw two of my good friends get married. I cried the whole time. I like bawled my head off. It was so beautiful. They're so in love. Then I like flew. I'll tell you guys what I did, okay? Listen to this. This is how much I love my friends, okay? So we go to Scotland. We fly to Scotland. We're there for a week. We go to my friend's wedding. So we drive. Need the accent. The Scottish accent. I was trying to learn it while I was there. So we go to the, we drive in a bus, we take a bus, an hour and a half to get to the wedding. We go to the wedding, it's amazing, it's incredible, it's beautiful. We finish at midnight. We drive an hour and a half back to Glasgow from the wedding. We sleep for 2 hours. Then we get on a plane, fly to Toronto. It's now 11 a.m. in Toronto. I get home, I unpack, I pack, and then I drive 3 hours up north to a cottage for a bachelorette. So I went straight from the wedding to somebody else's bachelorette. Like, literally, like, 24 hours later, had to cross the ocean. It was so worth it. I'm so happy, but my body is so weak. So bear with me. My voice is not 100%. My body is not 100%. My soul is like 150%. I just had the best time and I'm so happy to be back. You know, when you come home and you're just like, yes, yes. Like, I had an amazing time, but I'm so happy to be home. I'm so happy to be back here streaming for you guys. I'm so happy to be here. I was so looking forward to being back and being here with you guys. So I'm just overjoyed. I'm over the moon. I had an incredible week. I'm so happy to be back. And but my body is weak. I'm happy to be back. Thanks, Aaron. Oh, you've got a story for me, Mix? Okay. I can't wait to hear the story. And something's up with the thingy. It says 5 months ago. Did you hit refresh? It said 5 months ago before I played it, like, just right now. It did say 5 months ago before that. Hit refresh. Try that. Oh, God. Okay, I'm scared. I'm scared. Where's the amp? I'm direct in, so there's no amp. Third refresh worked. Okay, perfect. Put gain. I was trying to figure out how to put the gain before this, but I couldn't figure it out. I did try to add the gain onto it, and I couldn't figure it out, so I'm sorry. That I tried. I tried. I don't have... Well... Oh, I don't think I could do that. It's on the amp, usually. I know. I'm going, like, direct in, so I don't have an amp. And I tried using the software to add the game, but I couldn't get it to work. I was probably doing it wrong. But I tried. I tried my best. And it's not... It's not gonna be good, so. Yeah. I tried to do it before the stream, and I just, like, couldn't figure it out, and then ran out of time to figure it out. Also, yeah. It's not gonna be good regardless. Okay. Here's Master of Puppets. Here is Master of Puppets by Metallica. God help me. Are you attempting the riff? Why didn't you just do the chords? I'm not doing the riff. Do not worry. I am not doing the riff. Do not get excited. The riff is not happening. Tesno Pesto, hello. Hiya. I love that little cat. Okay. No, I'm not. Okay. You guys, I'm just gonna do it. Okay. I'm just gonna do it. And it's not going to be good, and that is okay. We can't all be good at everything all the time. Sometimes we have to be bad at stuff. That's all I'm doing. All right. Here it is. Thank you. Puppets cover for you. Mix. There you go. Thank you so much for the request. Thank you so much for the emotes. Whew, okay, let me switch back here. Thank you for the collabs. If we keep it on acoustic guitar, skip the intro riff, it's actually a pretty good cover. I wondered what you would think, Kinmin, because if you guys don't know, he's a big, big Metallica guy right here. So I was like, oh god. And Kinmin can play the whole riff and everything, so I knew he was going to judge me super hard for this. For this song. Permanent list. Okay, I guess it's going on the permanent list. I'll do it on acoustic next time though. The electric is hard. It's hard to sing with the electric just because it's hard to hear, and if I put the headphones on, there's a lag, like there's a slight delay and then I don't know how to get rid of, and that is quite the challenge. Bromzer, hello. Do I know any Boston songs? Do I know any Boston songs? That is a good question. Let me see. Let me find out here for you. Let me find out if I do know a Boston song. Mix, you're the goat. You are the goat. You are the goat. You asked for it, you got it. And I'll tell you something else. I got home yesterday at 3 p.m. After going to Scotland, then going to the Bachelorette, I got home yesterday at 3 p.m. and had between 3 p.m. yesterday and 8 p.m. today to learn that song. And I had to work a full day of work today as well.
Indecision. I don't care if I get behind. People living in competition. All I want is to have my peace of mind. You just keep on staying.
I can't remember how that first bit goes. Okay. I might be able to sing this song. Let me just quickly hear. I can't remember just how the beginning goes. Peace of mind. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Now if you're feeling kind of low about the dues you've been paying, future's coming much too slow, and you wanna run but somehow you just keep on staying, can't decide on which way to go. Mm-hmm. much for the follow, Bromzer. Thank you. Am I saying your name right? Let me know if I'm saying it right or if I'm not saying it right at all. Let's see. Mick says, next time I get learn a song, it'll be for Kian on guitar and you on vocals. Cannot be done. He actually plays it all on bass. It would be amazing, actually, if he came over and we did it here. But I feel like he would make me go over to his place, and I don't want to go all the way to his place. But that's probably how it would have to go. But, yeah, you know what? Maybe one day we will do that. All right. Peace of mind. What else? I don't know how this take a look ahead. They just keep on getting, doesn't mean too much to me. Get a drum player for your band. I want to. Soon we'll have a drummer for the band. Soon we will. Okay. Peace of mind. You'll be the agent. Perfect. All right, let's see if I can do a little live learn here. That's how the beginning is. Okay. A little Boston cover for you guys. There's a little live learn from Zer. Thank you so much for the request. I hope you like that one. I've never played or sang that before, so that was a full live learn there for you. Oh, Mix. Okay, we'll see you shortly in a few. See you soon. All right, you guys, let me know if there's anything else you would like to hear. I would love to play you guys some more requests. I've got some things in the queue that I haven't played in a while, but yeah, I would love to play you some songs. Drunk Bard says, "Oh, set fire to the rain." You guys are making me work today. You're making me work. Put me to work. It's my first day back. It's my first day, and you guys are putting me to work.
Oh, my heart. It's a failure to claim it. Dark and I was over.
This is so funny because this was just a live learn too. This is barely a song as well. This is practically also a live learn. I played this once before on stream. Before we dive into this next song, I will tell you guys what the theme is for today. And today's theme is good versus evil. I love that you put Amazon here. That was good. We timed it almost perfectly, and I love that you put Amazon because you know how I feel about Jeffrey. Bezos. How do you guys request a song from the list? I'm kind of new here. Okay, so right underneath that how thingy, there is a link. You click on that, and once you get to the list of songs, there should be like a little thingy on the side that says request song. So that's one way to do it. And the other way to do it is to put exclamation mark SR and then the name of the song that you would like to hear. And if you are not seeing anything on the list that you like, you can do what you did before and see if I know any songs. But if I don't know it, I don't know. If it's on the list, I do know it. Otherwise, you can shout some things out and see if I know it. Like that Boston Live Learn, and I'll just do my best. Was that a mistake, or is that the song you're after? Was that the song? My first question to you guys for today's theme is, do you believe in good and evil? Do you believe that there is good and there is evil? Do you believe? That's my first question to you guys. Can we get a poll? You drunk bar, do you believe in the the balance? I was like, the beslanks. I'm like, what is that? What is the beslanks? I was getting scared. I was like, what's happening? The balance, the great balance. I'm a firm believer in the great balance. But the question is, yeah, do you believe in good and evil? Does evil exist? Do good and evil balance each other out? Brumzer, I believe in my guitar. Yes, rock on. Baslangs is another cult. I was scared. I was like, are they coming for us? We're not ready to fight another cult. I mean, another community. Okay, but Bromser says, yes, there is good and evil. Okay, I'm curious to see what you guys all think about this. And then I'll tell you what I think. In the meantime, I'm going to play Set Fire to the Rain. Fire to the Rain, or part of it, most of it, some of it. Thank you so much for the request, Drunk Bard. That one was just for you. Oh. Thank you for the collapse. Yes. Wins 75% of the vote. 75% of you guys believe in good and evil. Okay, so then my next question to you is, do you believe that people are born evil or do they turn evil? Actually, yeah, better way to phrase this. Are people born inherently good or inherently evil? Like you're born either inherently good or evil, or you become good or evil throughout your life. Does that make sense? Are you born good or evil, or do you become good or evil? What do you believe? Are you predisposed to be good or evil? Or does your life experiences turn you good or evil. And Brome, sir, let me know your song request. Yeah, today's the day of the bots, apparently. They're just greeting me, giving me a warm welcome. A warm welcome back. Okay, Chu King says, I can't pick either choice. My belief is that everyone is born good. And some people become evil. No song for now. Okay, no worries. No worries at all. If you see a song you like, or if you think of something that you want me to randomly try and learn, you just let me know. You let me know. And I'm gonna do Strange Love in the meantime. By, who's this by? Simple Creatures. That's it. That's it. First Frat Cabo, that cannot be right. Strange love, lie on the floor like strangers. All of the good vibrations. Why don't I know where I came from this? Friend, how is your little bundle of joy? You're absolutely exhausted. I've heard that's what happens. I've heard that's how it generally goes. I have heard that that is how it goes. She's perfect. Oh. Oh, well, congratulations again. That is so exciting. I'm so, so happy for you. Do you think that your daughter was born good? We're talking about good versus evil today. Chu King says people are born good and then they become evil. Bromzer, do I have a shorter name? You can call me Taylor. You can call me T. You could call me Dragonfly. You can call me whatever you like. Tesno Pesno says, some people are born with it, some learn. We're even. Some people think you're born good or evil. Some people think you become good or evil. I like the idea of being born good and then becoming evil. Okay, Tesno Pasno says, I watched a lot of interviews of psychopaths and such from YouTube during the summer. There was an interesting one by a mother of a psychopathic kid. Go on, tell us more. Gold Ranger says, I can teach her all I can. The choice is up to her. That's a good way of looking at it. I think that's a really good way of looking at it because so many parents like want their kids to be like the way they want, but it's like, what can you do? They're all in little people. I'm with you. I think all you can do is like teach them the way. Gold Ranger says, I don't think people are born evil. Or good. I don't think people are born evil or good. I'm with you, Gold Ranger. I feel like people are not born good or evil. But I don't know that I believe in evil. I do not know that I believe in evil. I don't know. I don't know that I do, because I'll tell you why. Because people that do bad things are often, like, in a lot of pain. And when you're hurting inside, what you feel inside is what you put outside. So, like, is someone evil because, like, they were bullied and then they became a bully because someone bullied them and they didn't know what to do with that and then they bullied? Does that make them evil? Does it? I don't know. I don't know. Aaron says, sorry, dozed off. Don't like how early the sun is setting. I was so sleepy today in the afternoon. I was like, whoa, I'm going to fall asleep. But I managed to stay awake. But I'm with you. It's a sleepy time of year. Aaron says, we all have both light and dark inside of us. What matters is the part we choose to act on. I'm with you there. I agree with that as well. Like, I think we all have the capability to be really good and really bad. Tesno Pesno says, the mother told that she never knew if the kid was going for his mother or just punch her in the face. Everyone around her said you should teach your kid better. Oh, wow. Yeah. Some people are born buttholes. Gold Ranger, yeah, see? Like, so is evil really real? You raise a good point, Aaron. I'm sorry to hear that. That's awful. I'm sorry that happened to you, but, like, good for you for not turning evil because of it. That could have easily been your villain origin story. But good for you for not becoming evil. But I'm sorry to hear that. That really sucks. I'm very hopeful for kids these days because, like, I feel like bullying was just, like, okay when we were growing up. And now it's, like, not okay at all. There's so many anti-bullying campaigns. Like, it's so great. But it just didn't exist as much back then. Say no to evil. Testo, pesto. And she raised him to adulthood, and he got diagnosis so they could actually talk about things still. The kid tried to fit in, but he just didn't care for things that normal people did. Like human emotions. That's a good point. If you don't have emotions, it's kind of hard to... Kind of hard to be a good person if you don't have emotions or empathy. Oh, Drunk Bard, you also were bullied and chose to be a good person. Oh, my heart goes out to you guys. That sucks. It sucks being a kid and getting bullied, but, like, good for you guys for still being good people. That's so admirable. That is so admirable. Every villain is lemons. Oh, Bromzer, that is a great question. I love that question. Do you guys believe in evil as, like, an evil being? Or do you believe that it is the actions that we do? What do you guys think? You weigh in on your thoughts on evil while I play this song. Guitar. I remember how this song goes. Here we go.
Give me that guitar and throw me in a crowded room. She bit her lip and kissed me hard. Just drag me down the darkest night with you. Pose your moment, frozen at the bar, your reflection in the glass. Don't you forget just who you really are. Strange love, don't let the madness change us. All of the good vibrations roll on for one more.
For you by Simple Creatures. Okay, let's see. What are we thinking? Is evil an evil being, or is it the actions that we do? Kinman said actions. A.A. Ron said actions. Testo Pasno says, I had one kid in my childcare that I felt like he was evil. He became a bald bodybuilding far right as an A bald bodybuilding far right as an adult. There's so much to unpack there. There's so much to unpack there. I feel like Disney did a disservice to bald people. Because I feel like Disney taught us that, like, anyone bald or, like, with a beard is evil. But Jason Statham has proved that there are plenty of good people who are bald. So I'm gonna disregard the bald part from Testo Pasto. I'm gonna disregard that because despite what Disney has told me, yeah, beards, mustaches, despite what Disney has told me, I know that there can be good bald people in the world. Being bald is not a sign of evil, Testo Pasto. The far right, I'll side with you there. Testo says, I kind of knew that was going to happen and didn't want anything to do with him. Probably for the best. Okay, Aaron says, my mom has a few stories like that. She's been a teacher 40 years or so, with emphasis on special ed, seen a whole lot. Oh, I bet. I bet. Good for her for teaching spec ed, though. Tesno, some people just don't care. Some people want to create pain. I guess that matters a lot. It's both kind of the same, but you can also make a person like that by abusing. And people may hurt each other, even though they don't mean it. That's the thing. I'm like, I feel like, I don't know if I believe in, like, evil, like, pure evil. Or, like, people that just, like, hurt people because they don't know how to be better, you know? Drunk Bard is another one for actions. So nobody believes in, like, a demonic power that, like, tempts you. No one believes in that. Or does anyone believe in that? Chew King says, I thought the bald part was a reference to the group of, oh, I see. I was like, I don't know how that's related. I was like, I've known some good bald people. But I see what you're saying. It can be a symbol of something else. I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying, Tesno Vesno. The age of 18, that is so young. That might be evil, honestly. Guess I gotta find my razor to not be evil. Shave all the facial hair. I know, Disney messed us up. All the princes are, like, clean shaven, and then there's, like, all the evil dudes with beards. It's wrong, I say. It's wrong. We've got to petition Disney for, like, a prince with a beard. A good, wholesome prince with a beard. It's not in the rules, though. When I was in Scotland, the rules remind me. When I was in Scotland, they were like, people were like, we would be so happy for you to put on a kilt. And it just reinforced that I'm so glad we wear kilts for all our official cult business. I feel like the Scots would be proud. Humans can be evil on their own. They don't need, like, a demonic spirit tempting them. He also had that evil look in his eyes, like, under the brows and grim smile. So stereotypical. You know what I do think looks a bit evil is having no eyebrows. That is a little bit, for me, should I do one more song before the tarot card reading? These songs all look hard. Do you guys want to hear anything? Are there songs that you guys want to hear? Maybe I'll play It's Okay to Cry. I was not a teardrop in your eye. I never thought I'd see you cry. Way to take a shot at those with alopecia. Oh, God. We are getting canceled today. It's over for us. Okay, I have another question for you guys. Okay, wait. Tesno Pesno says, there was another kid also, but I felt like he had just really dysfunctional family in the end, since I knew also his brother, and he had sort of a different scale of problems. See, it's so hard to know. But I guess maybe there is a difference between, like, someone that's, like, evil and someone that's just, like, hurting and hurts people and doesn't realize versus someone who's actually evil. Okay, here's my question, my next question for you guys. Do you think Amazon is evil? Do you think Jeffrey Bezos is evil? Do you think that the billionaires of the world are evil? I read that Jeffrey Bezos could give $100,000 to every person on the planet and still be a billionaire. Do you think you have to be evil to be a billionaire? Isn't that really the only way you could become a billionaire? By being evil? That's my question for you guys. I don't know how to do this poll. Do you think all billionaires are evil? Yes or yes? That is the poll. Tesno Pesno says not all billionaires. Oh, and let's see. I have some weird memory of him punching me in the stomach when I was very young. But don't know if it's just imagining or something. That sounds horrible. I'm so sorry. are all billionaires? No, the answers were yes or yes. The drunk Bart is with me. Don't really know Bezos that well. He hasn't been in media in Finland. Oh, you're so lucky, Tesno Pasno. You're so lucky that he is not in your media. I wish he was not in our media. It's okay to cry. I was that a teardrop in your eye? I never thought I'd see you cry. Okay. Just know you've got nothing to hide. Oh, you feel like Elon Musk is more evil. You raise a good point. Billionaire is then again different than millionaire. Is there something wrong if a person isn't good with just as multimillionaire? Because I think I know what you're asking. And I would say a billionaire is different than a millionaire because, like, you could become a millionaire just doing your thing. But to become a billionaire, you kind of have to do some bad stuff. You can't really become a billionaire in an ethical, sustainable, human rights way. You can't really go straight to billionaire. You could become a millionaire, but billionaire, you kind of have to take advantage of people. You kind of have to take advantage of the poor to become a billionaire. Public lies is one sort of evil. Like, if you lie to gain some big benefits in front of everyone, it is a sort of evil. You need to step on others to get to that level, so I guess evil? Yeah, like, would Jeffrey Bezos still be a billionaire if he paid everyone, all of his employees, a living wage? All of them. And gave them health benefits, and sick days, and paid vacation. If he did all that, would he still be a billionaire? I don't know. And I'm talking, like, all the people, all the way down. All the people making all the products that are sold on Amazon. If they all made a living wage with health benefits and paid vacation and paid sick leave, would Amazon still be what it is? Would he still be a billionaire? I don't know. These are the things that keep me up at night. He probably would be. You think he would still be a billionaire? But then why don't all these people get paid a living wage? That is my question. If he could do it and still be a billionaire, why doesn't he do it? Is it greed? That's evil. It's one of the seven deadly sins, isn't it? That's my next question. What are your thoughts on the seven deadly sins? Amazon secretly paid some employees to make posts on social media about how great it was to work for Amazon. They got caught and stopped doing it. That's messed up. That's messed up. That's what I think. All right, here is It's Okay to Cry. If I can find my other internet window. Yes, I can. All right, here is It's Okay to Cry.
Saying this, I know that scares you. All of the big occasions you might have missed, no, I accept you. And I don't even need to know your reasons. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. I think you sometimes forget I would know you best. I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I think your inside is your best side. I sat a teardrop in your eye. I never thought I'd see you cry. Just know whatever hurts, it's all mine. It's okay to cry. It's okay to cry. I see the truth through all the lies. Even after all this time, just know you've got nothing.
Sophie. Okay, let's see. Tesno Pasno says, I feel like people making laws that don't protect the most vulnerable are sort of evil. That's a good point. Like, you could blame Jeffrey Bezos, or you could blame the people that allow him to operate. Like, deep inside, they actually don't care, even if they say they do. That also contains Amazon working policies, I guess. You raise a very good point, Tesno Fasno. You raise a very good point. Thank you for the emotes. Thank you. Let's see. Aaron says, I forget the person, but there was a billionaire or maybe multimillionaire in Australia that ran a business and after some studies and reviews or something, increased all salaries to 70K per year minimum, took some pay cuts for himself, and a few years later, the company profits were significantly better than before the changes. I heard about that guy. That guy, not evil. For sure. I wish more people were like that. Tesno Pasno says, if I decide, I would test every leader for psychopathy since it can be done. At least then we know if they don't have a conscience. That's a good point. They should. Like, there should be, like, a mental test before you can become, like, a country's leader. Like, even Bill Gates does some things that are sort of weird for pure evil. So maybe there's something else. There's also the thing that one psycho can manipulate a lot of people around him and then they kind of do the work and actually start to believe things. That's another good point. Is like people could be influenced. Okay, here's my next question for you guys, which is, if, let's say, you have been evil, if you have been evil, how much good do you have to do to make up for the evil? Can it ever make up? Do you have to do, like, something equally good? Like, I'll put it this way. Let's say someone murdered someone. If they saved someone else's life, do you think that that would balance out? Or someone, like, stole some food, but then later they gifted some food to someone else. Does that balance out? I mean, I guess stealing food isn't evil, but let's say they stole a flat-screen TV. Just because they wanted to. But then they gift that flat-screen TV to someone who really is in need. Does it balance out? Does it balance? Do you believe that? That good deeds, an equally good deed would balance out an evil deed? Do you believe that? Or do you think you need, like, twice as many good deeds to balance out the evil deed? Aaron says, now you actually get into real cult doctrine. I mean, when you put it that way. Tasno Masno says, on a personal level, it can't be fixed, but we have penalties in society for that. That is true. That we do. I don't think a billionaire can do much to polish his bad things if he hasn't done it while making the money. What if when the billionaire died, he donated all his money to charity? Would that absolve all the evil things that he or she did in life? He, she, or they did in life. Yeah, like Robin Hood. Like, we all believe Robin Hood was a good guy, right? Do we? Robin Hood, good or evil? Thoughts. Let's do a tarot card reading. Let's do a tarot card reading today. I think that's what I want to do. All right. Can I please get a single card message for everyone watching the stream today? One single card message, please. Scorpion, congratulations on that 60 stream streak. That's incredible. Thank you so much. That just makes me so happy. Thank you, Scorp. I saw you kind of lurking. I saw that you've been lurking. You would not lose your streak, eh? Thank you so much. That warms my heart. Okay, let's get the single card message. What do we need to hear today? What do we need to hear today? Scorp, you've been here the whole time? Of course you have. Of course you have. What a card to get today. What an excellent card. Ooh, everything's wet all of a sudden. Oh, I think my water spilled a little bit. For a whole month, Scorp. I was gone for 1 week. I was away for one entire week. And that was it. Okay. let's see. A Aaron says, to an extent of a bad deed, it can be redeemed, but there are some deeds that are unforgivable. I'm with you there. Some things I don't think you can balance out no matter how good of a deed that you do. But some things I think could be balanced out. I feel like it depends on how evil the thing is. All right, today's card is the Ace of Pentacles. Potential, abundance, wealth, and gratitude. As with all aces, the first card of Pentacles signals enormous capacity for the theme of the suit. Pentacles, like the crystal, represent riches and all things tactile. It's funny, we were just talking about billionaires, and look at the card that we get. The possibility for abundance and prosperity rises on your horizon when the Ace of Pentacles appears in a reading. The prospect of wealth in all its definitions lights up your world. It can assume many forms, but unless you take action, the Ace of Pentacles gifts merely remain a distant possibility. This is your call to begin to direct your energies towards alchemizing something of value. Note that its worth can only be determined by you. Time to get to work and assess exactly how you'll materialize the fortune you dream of. Be sure to acknowledge the jeweled position you're in and practice gratitude for it. This will create more of what you're already thankful for. What an amazing card for today. Ah! Abundance is on your horizon, friends. Abundance is on the horizon. It is on the horizon. This is an excellent card. All you have to do is capitalize on it. All you have to do is reach out and grab it. All you have to do is take that step, whatever step that you have been wanting to take towards your wealth, whether that's asking for a promotion, whether that's asking someone out on a date. It could be abundance in a different way. It doesn't have to necessarily be monetary abundance. It could be abundance in terms of friendship or love. It could be a new friend that you've been wanting to make, and you just have to do that reach out, and then you're gonna have an abundance of friendship. But there is abundance, just like this crystal sparkling on the horizon. Your abundance is on the horizon. But the key to manifesting your abundance is gratitude. It's always gratitude, you guys. The cure for sadness, gratitude. The cure for anger, gratitude. How do you manifest gratitude? It always comes back to gratitude. You cannot manifest from a place of lack. You cannot sit around being like, no one's ever loved me, and manifest love. You cannot sit around being like, I've never had any good friends, and manifest new friends. You cannot sit around and be like, I've always been poor, and manifest money. You cannot manifest from a place of lack. You have to first acknowledge what you have. Maybe you've never had a lasting love, but maybe you've had really short, beautiful loves. Maybe you haven't had a lot of friends, but maybe you've had one really good friend. You have to show gratitude. You have to be grateful for what you do have. You can even be grateful for the possibility of friendship or love or wealth on the horizon. The fact that you're healthy and able to work for money or able to make money, or the fact that you have a job where you could get promoted. It starts with gratitude. Start with the gratitude and the abundance will follow. Take whatever step. Start with the gratitude. Take the step and the abundance will follow. That's what this card is telling you. There is abundance on your horizon. All you have to do is be grateful and take that step, whatever it is, towards maybe it's buying a lottery ticket. Whatever the step is, practice your gratitude and take that step. And there is wealth. There's wealth and riches on the horizon for you. Excellent card for today. I'm going to do a last call for song requests. Let me know if there's anything you guys would like to hear. I would love to play you some more songs. Oh, Kinman beat me. And 100% of you said that Robin Hood is good, not evil. Even though he steals, even though he does crime. Interesting. Ooh, white flag, Wiccan. Tasno, Vasno, I don't know what that is. I'm so sorry. I do not know that. Do not know that song. Do you guys, here's a question for you guys. Do you want to see my hairy coo? Do you want to see my hairy coo? Do you? My hairy coo. Maybe I'll show you after The Legend of Taylor the Great. Maybe I'll show you guys my hairy coo. Yeah. My hairy coo. I'll show you guys after this song. After The Legend of Taylor the Grape. We're getting banned. It's very hairy. It's a very hairy coo. Okay, I'm going to play The Legend of Taylor the Grape, and then I'm going to show you guys my hairy coo. Legend of Taylor the Grape, just for you, Scorp. Thank you for the request, and thank you for the emotes, and thank you for the claps. I want nothing to do with this debauchery. Are you guys ready? Are you ready to see my hairy coo? I'm so excited about it. It's my hairy coo, also known as a Highland cow. She's from Scotland. What do you guys think? What do you guys think of my hairy coo? Okay, let's see. Tesno Vesno says, there's one streamer who does both sorts of streams, but I've seen him advertising normal music streams also on those other sites, which is interesting. On the other sites. Interesting. Scorp, that's not what you thought I was going to do. What did you think I was going to do? What were you guys thinking? Bet you weren't expecting this little hairy coo with a snoot. She's got a very uneven snoot, which is why I love her. Tesno Vesna says, one thing I've been thinking a lot is that does moral bend in between people if another person is distant enough? It might also cause millionaires not to care since no one gets near them. Oh, interesting. Like, if people are distant, does that impact, like, how good or evil they are to other people if other people are distant? That is very interesting. Pesno, pesno. Mix, welcome back. You're just in time for the last couple of songs here. I've got two more left in the queue. And while you were gone, I showed my hairy coo. My hairy coo. That's all that you've missed. Is my hairy coo. I've been bringing it everywhere with me. I'm obsessed. Oh, okay. Nice theme. Okay. Thank you. I feel like it got a little intense. Looks like Appa. If you've seen Avatar. Oh. I just looked it up. It does kind of look like that. A sky bison. Appa is a sky bison. And Honey here is a Highland cow from Scotland. Tesno Vesna says, at the same time, we can get actually closer even through internet in places like this and actually care for total strangers. You raise a good point. I just need some interaction and feeling of being understood. Kinman says a billionaire can redeem their sins if they donate millions of dollars in chat right now. Right now. Scotland! Scotland! I didn't learn to say very much. The only thing they taught me was, that's a lot of shite! That's all that I learned. And Harry Koo. Although I've been told that they don't actually say Harry Koo. But our tour guide did for just, you know. Tesno, Fesno, thank you. Thank you for the bit. 1 million bits. Thank you. That's what the Catholic Church did in the past. That did not go well. Yeah, you can totally get into heaven. All it costs is 5,000 bits right now. And I will totally put in a good word for you with the big guy. For sure, Z real Z's. Okay. I've got White Flag. I've got... I don't think she's gonna stay. I've got White Flag. Tesno, Fesno, thank you so much. 5,000 bits, you're going straight to heaven. Straight to heaven. Oh, Mix, you do not think... Oh, no, you think evil and good don't really exist. It's only perspective. I'm inclined to kind of agree with you because, like... Who determines what is good and what is evil? Like, our society does, but I think if you go to different countries, there's going to be a slightly different idea of, like, how good is good and how evil is evil. And what is good and what is evil. Can you take me seriously with... Is it ruining the stream? Mix says, take war as an example. That's a good point. Because, like... Tesno Pesno says, I think causing pain intentionally is kind of evil. What about pain, but to an end? Like your arm is dislocated and they have to pop it back in and it really hurts, but it fixes your arm. Okay, Mick says, take war as an example. The evil is always the other side. As I'm Lebanese, my country is right now getting bombed. I don't think they're evil, though. Yeah. I mean, I'm sorry to hear it. I'm sorry to hear it. It honestly breaks my heart, like how much conflict is going on in the world. And yeah, it's like, it's easy, like you said, it's easy to kind of say the other side is evil, but then everyone has their perspective. It's tough, it's challenging. It's a challenging thing, good versus evil. That's the story I want to tell you. I came to the US to visit family and got stuck here. Oh my gosh. That's really tough. I'm really sorry to hear that. And you can't get back home. That, my heart goes out to you, Mix. I'm sending you all the love. All the love, all the good vibes. I hope you are able to get back home. I hope that things do work out for you. That's really tough. Let's hope for peace. Let's hope for peace. Let's pray for peace. Let's send our positive vibes for peace. Absolutely. Okay. Tasno Basno says, causing pain intentionally is kind of evil, but like an animal might not understand the animal that is being eaten hurts. If you enjoy the part of causing pain, but you can also do it willingly. Let's see. Tesla says, I had a dentist as a kid that didn't use anesthetics. It's kind of evil. My dentist did that to me one time as well. My dentist was like, you don't need to be frozen. I'm just going to fill your cavity. When I was a kid, I haven't had cavities since I was a kid. My dentist was like, I'm just going to fill your cavity with no freezing. And it hurt so much. And I was like, why would you do that? Are you just trying to save a couple bucks? Mick says, I met an Israeli guy in a store. He also wants peace. We shook hands and got off. See, evil doesn't exist, only perspective. I'm with you. I think, you know, there's a lot of people who want peace. I think there's a lot of people, and it's tough when governments... I mean, governments is where I might say where the evil lies. Because when you talk to, like, the people, so often the people want peace. It's the governments. Aaron says, it's always the citizens that are hurt in conflict. Governments don't always get that. Heart is with you. Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh my gosh, that's not necessary. He removed a tooth? Removed a tooth with no anesthetic. No freezing, no nothing. Goodness gracious, that is so brutal. Yeah, Mix, I'm with you. They want what's best for, like, the country or, like, the power of the country, but not the people. Oh, it's tough. It is tough. All right, you guys, do you remember music? Remember music? I'm gonna play White Flag. Killing in the name of mix. Come on now. All right. I'm gonna play White Flag here. For Aaron. And also for Drunk Bird.
Tell you that, but if I didn't say it, I'd still have felt it. Where's the sense in that? I promise I'm not trying to make your life harder or return to where you were.
Request Aaron. Thank you so much. Taz Novesta, thank you for singing along. Okay. Whew. Hotel Potato. Okay, maybe I could squeeze in Hotel Potatoville as well. Oh, that is really the last one, though. I will squeeze in Hotel Potatoville, and then that is it. On the topic of war and metal songs, give Homeback Ginger a listen. I like Ginger. I will give that a listen. Megadeth, Rust in Peace, Polaris is good also. Okay. I feel like the stream is slowly turning into like a metal stream. Just bit by bit. Thank you for the collabs. Thank you so much. Jay Bear! Did you miss my theme song? Is that Taylor the Grape? Yes. Yes, you did miss it. Unfortunately. Gotta learn how to rip then. Can't escape. Just give me a cool, like, 5 years, and then I'll learn how to riff. How about that? Where are these chords? I lost the chords to my own song. Where are they? Okay, I found it. Found it. 5 years then, I'll wait. Seems reasonable. Oh my goodness. Jay Bear, how are you doing? I'm sorry you missed my theme song. Okay, last two songs for Shruzy Realsies. I said I wasn't going to do 2 hours, and here I am doing 2 hours. I just love you guys so much. Okay, here's Daydreams. Scorp, thank you for all the emotes. Thank you. Ooh, it's in Discord. Okay, wicked. Along with Heart of Gold from Passenger. Okay, amazing. I will go listen. Jaber, you're good. You made it home. Good. Nothing better than coming home, eh? It is a good feeling. Thank you guys for the claps. Thank you for the emotes. I literally wrote Hotel Potatoville chords. Okay, everyone, get your potatoes ready. This is the last song of the evening. Get out your potatoes. Get them ready. Whew. First day back, full 2 hours for you guys. Taters. Taters. Can we get the taters command working too? Oh, a sweet potato. Love me a good sweet potato. Do you call it a sweet potato or a yam? Or a yam? Oh, and a unicorn potato? Love it. I love all the different potatoes. Let's go. Let's go, potatoes.
The night man we are programmed to receive. You can
Hotel Potatoville for you. Thank you guys so much for all your potatoes. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you for the collabs. Thank you guys for all your emotes. I love that. Oh, I love that mix. Oh, thank you guys for all your song requests. Mix, thank you for pushing me to do Metallica today. That was a blast. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for the Boston Live Learn from Bromzer. And thank you for the follow, Chew King. Thank you for resubscribing, Tusno Fesno. Thank you for the bits. And Scorpion, congratulations on your 60 stream streak. Bow, 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 bow. I am just, by the time we raid out, I'm going to be at 2 hours on the dot. It is time for me to have a big sleep. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thank you for the warm welcome back. I am so happy to be back. And I will be back again on Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. ET for more music and magic and mayhem. I will see you all next time. Bye.